The Boy Scouts are going to start accepting girls. Their announcement, they said that this decision is true to the BSA's mission and core values outlined in the Scout Oath and Law. The values of scouting, trustworthy, loyal, helpful, kind, brave, and reverent, for example, are important for both young men and women. They said they're going to start accepting girls, even though they will have boy dens and girl dens. So there will be no co-ed dens, they'll keep them separately. Club dens will still be single gender, but will begin admitting girls in 2018. And then have a system for them to become Eagle Scouts as soon as 2019. The Girl Scouts are pissed. The Girl Scouts say that this is just a way to try to steal girls from the Girl Scout organization. They say, we're disappointed in the lack of transparency as we learn that you are surreptitiously testing the appeal of a girl's offering to millennial parents. Furthermore, it is inherently dishonest to claim to be a single gender organization while simultaneously endeavoring upon a co-ed model. What do you guys think? Thoughts, 5 words or less.
I better still get cookies. Why though?
What Grace said.
Scouts on her.
I was gonna do something with like the, because I remember my brother's an Eagle Scout, so I remember going to his little meetings.
I was a Girl Scout.
You were. Was too.
I was a Girl Scout. My mom was my troop leader.
So what was it like?
It was boring. That's why I quit. I didn't like
How
it.
How long were you a Girl Scout?
Well, okay. The things that the Girl Scouts do is like sewing crafts, like that, like more girly type thing. So I can see how girls who are a little more tomboyish like me might like being outdoors, like learning how to tie knots and shit, like learning how to build fires. Mm-hmm. But my thing with the Girl Scouts is if they are so afraid that the Boy Scouts are gonna take the girls, why not just change their curriculum to add more tomboyish type of activities?
Darren, what an excellent point you bring up. And I actually have found a study from CNN that
really?
Does illustrate
Do
that
tell.
With some statistics.
Okay, let's see.
The study found that girls are offered more art activities than boys, but science activities make up only 2% of their activities and 6% for the boys. The girls' activities are more communal, with 30% of their badge work taking place in groups, while the boy work is more self-oriented, with less than 20% of their work taking place in a group. The reason why I think that's important is because a lot of times you see this false equivalency between Boy Scouts of America and Girl Scout USA, I think, because they're two different organizations.
Yes.
They're not actually, they're very separate. They're not counterparts to each other. And that's, I think, important because this is definitely a business decision, as we've seen that attendance for enrollment in the Boy Scouts has gone down, I think, almost a third since 2012 or something crazy like that. I think my brother was maybe the last Eagle Scout ever.
Ever.
Well, that's something that they're pointing to is the girls have Girl Scouts cookies. And the Girl Scout cookies are like the thing that everyone knows about them. There's the guys tried to do popcorn or something weird like that and never caught on.
My sister
Who
was
needs
a Girl Scout.
To buy popcorn?
Like buy a bag of popcorn?
Well, you have Samoas. Why buy popcorn? You can have Samoas.
Girl Scouts. Okay, we'll talk about. But like the guys have Eagle Scouts, and Eagle Scouts
the
are really
zenith
good
of accomplishment.
Neil Armstrong was an Eagle Scout.
It'll get you into college, essentially. Yeah. Like that was a huge
really
thing. If you have Eagle Scout, put it on top.
Yeah.
Now let's talk about what's important, which is Girl Scout cookies are overrated.
The Samoas are, but I think the rest of them are.
Yeah, no. That's the most important.
Just lost Grace.
Take your mic off and
I love
get the hell off.
Grace
the
and I stopped being friends today because of a previous video and this. It's over. Like this was the straw that. What's your favorite Girl Scout cookie?
Thin Mints, and you put them in the freezer, and then you just wait for a rainy day to watch a movie.
Crunch, crunch.
Yeah,
on my
crunch,
thin
little crunch, crunch on a little Thin Mint, and then the Samoas. Is that Samoas?
Yeah, the Samoas are like the coconut ones with the chocolate.
The fake chocolate, not real.
I love a little.
I get it. I don't do the coconut.
Okay, yeah, some people aren't coconut people.
I'm a Jew who doesn't like macaroons, like it's sacrilege.
Do you like peanut butter type cookies?
I do, and I get those, and I eat, I'll finish
it. Like the
tagalongs. The tagalongs.
Yeah, tagalongs we do.
So good. But okay, then back to the topic at hand.
Yeah.
So some people were saying that this was a PC move, that it's too, you know, Boy Scouts. You know, you're involving Girl Scouts, like what the hell? This 107-year-old organization, no changes allowed to be made ever, only boys. I don't think this was a move for more politically correct. I think it was just to boost enrollment.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
I think that they saw a gap because of the programs that they provide versus what the Girl Scouts provide. And it is more attractive for some girls, the program options. So it makes sense. I think it'll be okay. I think there are still gonna be, like, for example, if Lizzie and I were at the age right now, Lizzie, Girl Scout, 100%.
Oh, yeah.
She would love the crafting. She would love the sewing.
It was a lot of crafting.
The team building.
And it was a lot of team building. And
Lizzie would love that. So. Me, I get to go camping with knives.
Yeah.
My brother got a merit badge for beekeeping and I believe also for rabbit thatch building. What the hell? That's amazing.
Yeah, there's see, a merit badge. I would have loved to do the Boy Scout activities.
That's so specific.
He built like a rabbit.
Thatchery. Like, I got my Thatchery badge. In 1642. Yeah.
And beekeeping, he said, was stressful.
Like, I mean, no, it sounds stressful.
Shit, there's bees.
I always thought that was so funny.
Do the Girl Scouts get badges?
Yeah, you get badges, but it's for like painting, pottery. Like.
Okay, well, first of all,
my Jason Tiebreaker.
So that's why I quit, because I was like, this is I didn't say this in like third grade. I was like, this is bullshit, Mom. I don't want to do this shit anymore. Like, well, this is so boring. Look, I loved being outside.
You
when
can
I was a
get
kid.
A. There's a gold award in Girl Scouts when you are in between 10th and 12th grade, and mm-hmm. you become an ambassador for the Girl Scouts. And I would be really curious if anyone actually went that far in the comment section below what the requirements were. Because Darren, maybe you were just a quitter and you quit before all the cool activities.
No, I mean I do know some girls that were in my troop that went on, you know, to get like the highest level that you can get in Girl Scouts, which I don't know.
It's the gold award.
It's the gold award.
Okay. Yeah, you like cross this bridge or something. I don't even know.
That sounds amazing. Like where what happens to dogs.
I definitely would have preferred to be in the Boy Scouts and doing their activities when I was a kid.
Right.
So I feel like if the Girl Scouts want to compete, just add some of those activities in. Sure, just add some more.
Nice. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. That's our show.
And I said nothing.
Did you have nothing to say? What did you want to say?
I don't even remember what I was going to say now. But
what
that
are you
was an illuminating and very enlightening conversation about Thatchery and
I know.
And
would cookies. You do Boy Scouts?
No. My little sister was a. My little sister. No one cares. Bye. See you guys later.
Oh, Jason.
No, that's cool. I don't like the cookies.